here at Christ Church in Kent Island, and we're going to visit some of the vendors at the farmer market. Come on in and join me. What do you have here on your tray?
Oh, wow. Well, we got our best-selling dish. It's called Amritsari Chole. And it's a version of chana masala, which is a chickpea dish that you find in Indian restaurants.
Yeah.
But it has more spices in it, you know, so it's more dynamic in flavor.
I see.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, well, I'll have to try one. Is that okay?
Absolutely.
Oh. That's good.
And by the way, this is the Sacred Kitchen.
Okay.
It's a vegan kitchen. And we have our baked goods over here, all gluten-free, of course, vegan as well. And we also have entrees and flatbreads, and rice dishes of different sorts, and we always have our herbal iced tea.
Wonderful.
Yep.
I'm here with Taylor from Night Kitchen Coffee. How are you?
I'm great, Renee. How are you?
Doing just fine. Tell us about your coffee.
So we're a small batch micro-watt coffee. We focus on really finding the finest coffees that we can find, buying them as close to direct from the farmer as we can possibly get. I either buy directly from the farm, or we buy through importers that we've custom selected who are buying direct from the farm. It means that the farmer's getting a much more equitable price for his product. There's a huge amount of work goes into growing coffee and producing it and getting it ready so I can take over and roast it. So I'm trying to do whatever I can to support the farmers, much like everybody else here at the farmers markets do.
Wonderful. And I understand you also handle your spices.
Yeah, so we came up with a whole series of culinary spice blends. We were working with one of the local meat farmers, and so we came up with a sausage blend, and it sort of has ballooned from that. So we're here today actually debuting three new spice blends that we just came up with and just came out with. One's a Creole seasoning based around the Cajun flavors that would be really traditional in the southern Louisiana. We do our take on a jerk seasoning, sort of the Caribbean and Jamaican flavors. And then finally, I did a blend that's based on Moroccan flavors. And these are all things that I've just been fascinated with cooking-wise, and we have a lot of fun with.
I bet you do. I have a husband that barbecues all the time, so I'll have to get some of the spice blends.
Sounds
give
great.
It a try.
Sounds great. And if you ever have any questions, you can check out our website, okay. www.nightkitchencoffee.com.
Oh, good.
We have all the information about our coffee, our spices, everything is there.
Wonderful. And you're here on Thursdays.
We're here on periodically on Thursdays, so
okay.
check the newsletter to make sure if you see when we're going to be here.
All right, will do. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you.
I'm here with Lindy, and Lindy's with the soup group from Christ Episcopal Church. How are you?
Just great, thanks. This is our Chinese pork meatball soup with noodles. So there are rice noodles, so it is gluten-free. Each week, all of our soups, there will almost always be as gluten-free as possible. There is always one vegan soup, one seafood soup, and one meat soup. So this Chinese chicken meatball soup is our meat soup this week, and it's in honor of Chinese New Year, which was just this past Sunday. So we are launching with that, and so cheers. That's what that
Thank
is.
Thank you so much.
And this is our creamy fish chowder, and this is made with fresh cod, and a splash of sherry and lots of heavy cream, unapologetically, and a lovely herb blend. And down here we have our...
I'm sorry, I gotta keep the mic.
Okay. This is our vegan soup today, which is a lentil, curried lentil with spinach and tomatoes. And so that has a wonderful curried flavor. We serve all of our soups. We offer them to be hot or cold so that when you're taking it home, some people want to eat it in the car on the way home, and then others will take it home then serve later, so those we have cold. And the other thing that's very cool about us is we are pretty much the reason the market is here, because we are the Christ Church Soup Group. And when we started hosting the farmers market, you know, we're now in our sixth year here. I had said that, well, if we're going to host them, we should be a part of it. And since I like to make soup, we started very simply back then 6 years ago. And it has grown into quite an enterprise, and it's all volunteer. All of the proceeds go back to the church. And over the last 5 years, we've donated over $100,000 back to our church.
That's wonderful.
And so the big highlight is, as you can see with the bags behind us, these are our pre-orders. And so all the people who work in Annapolis, Baltimore, and D.C. have the ability to send us a reply email, and we have everything waiting for them. So those are all packed cold, and people can pick it up until 7 o'clock at night.
We have Jamie here with us. How are you, Jamie?
I'm doing great. How are you doing?
Doing great. Tell me all about Lion.
Fantastic. We are located in St. Michael's, Maryland, and we make rum and other spirits from scratch in our distillery. And we're really excited to be part of the market this year. We found that people really enjoy trying our new coffee rum, and we have a curacao. We have some really fun, unique spirits.
I bet. Yeah. I bet. And I noticed that you have them in all sizes where you can try, or you can get your big bottle if you really enjoy it.
Absolutely. We offer samples at the market, but sometimes people are rushing to and from work, so we have little mini bottles that they can take to go, or full bottles. We also have one of our favorite mixers, which is a spicy non-alcoholic ginger beer. Makes a great dark and stormy cocktail. And then this week, one of the other vendors here, Magnolia Bakery, has made rum truffles using our dark caramel rum. So that's really fun.
It sounds delicious.
Yeah.
Yes, it does. Well, do you have a website?
We do. You can find us at liondistilling.com. You can purchase our products here or at stores in Kent Island, but you can't order online. You can just follow us for recipes and things like that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much.
Oh,
this
thank
was
you.
Fun. Diane, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, good. I am loving the place. The market is awesome.
It's your first time here, right?
Yes, it's my first time here. Tell me all about it.
Well, I'm really proud of the fact that we have a really large variety of things. A lot of markets I've been to, you may have like, you know, 8 or 9 vendors like that all have vegetables. So I try and have a really wide array of things. But we have meat and eggs, milk, butter, yogurt. We have olives, olive oil, balsamic vinegar. We have organic produce. We have lots of fruit in the summertime. But even right now, we have tons of apples and pears, which are seasonal right now. We have breads, and we have pierogies and granola and fresh pressed juices. Wheatgrass. I mean, it's an amazing array of products. We're open year-round,
okay.
Which is very unusual. There aren't that many markets in Maryland that are open year-round. We're open every Thursday, 3:30 to 6:30, at 830 Rum & Coke Road. We're inside for the wintertime, so it hasn't been very wintry lately, but it's still comfortable.
Yeah.
All of the vendors, except for, I think, one, take plastic. So I think a lot of people are surprised. I have people every week that, you know, walk in and are very surprised that we take plastic. Actually, plastic has probably increased our sales over the last, I'd say, 3 years, 30 to 40%.
Yeah.
So it's, yeah, that's been a really big get for us.
I hope you'll join us here at the Kent Island Farmers Market. It's open on Thursdays. Come on by, and on your way in, stop and get your kettle corn.